Hello friends, welcome on stitchingmall.com. Today I'll show you one method of making a simple anchor thread neck design on a pleated top. So this is about 1.5 meter fabric. It's folded from the top and on the sides also, on the back side of the fabric, I fold it and we'll cut front and back together. If you don't want pleated design on back side of the dress, then you can cut that in simple way. Now we'll start cutting, but before that we'll keep 7 inch from the folded side for our pleat. You can also make gather or ruffles by this method if you don't make a pleat by using this extra 7 inch fabric in the front. So here I put the line. Now we start marking the shoulder. Half shoulder and 1/4 inch. Then we'll mark our armhole, waist length, and full length I'm keeping 25 inches. Now we extend these markings. It's very printed fabric, so I don't know if you are able to easily notice, but these are the straight lines. Neck width I am keeping 3 inch. Formula I've mentioned everywhere, you can refer to that as well. The front neck length I'm keeping about 5.5 inches, but maximum you can keep 7 inch inclusive of shoulder seam. And the back neck length, that would be 2 inch. Width would be same, 3 inch. Now we keep the armhole. We mark the armhole length and keep 1/2 inch for shoulder slope. Join shoulder slope with the neck where the neckline ends. After this, we keep about 1/2 inch up from this armhole thing. But before that, we just check what is our chest line. So our chest line, we have added 1 inch to the chest line. And waist, you can keep just 1/4 of the waist line. And then we keep the bottom and cut the neck, shoulder, armhole. On the sides, we need to keep about 1 inch on the sides, and then we'll cut from the sides. We are cutting front and back together. On the bottom, I'm keeping the back part about 1 inch more than the front part. You can keep the length even more. Then we'll remove the inside, that is the back part of the top or the kurti, and we'll cut the armhole a little bit steeper. So we'll cut it 1/2 inch inside. These are only the front armholes. Now using the side fabric, we'll cut short sleeves. So we fold the fabric. This was a side fabric which was left while cutting the armhole. So we need to keep beyond this curvy thing, we need to keep 1 inch extra on the seam side. We need to cut it a little less steeper. And then we cut the extra from the lower. I'm not keeping it 1 inch extra, but you please take care that you keep it 1 inch extra from the lower side of the sleeve if you are cutting by this method. So here we are having 2 pieces of the sleeve which is cut, and then we need to cut, rather shape, the front armhole that will go slightly inside from the lower and will merge with the outer part of the sleeve. And we make a smaller notch, and here our sleeve is cut. So this is the sleeve. Here this thing is done, sleeve is cut. Now we'll make a pleat in the front and make design on the neck. So we kept buckram folded. This is about 10 inch by 10 inch. Rather, width wise you can keep it 6 inch, because 3 inch is our neck width and 3 inch is our shoulder. The total shoulder was 7 1/4 of an inch. We don't need 10 inch. You can keep it lesser, but to be on safer side, I'm keeping it, I'm showing you as 10 by 10 on folded side. Then you mark it till the bottom, and from the folded side also, whatever is the neck length, the front neck length that you want, I'm keeping it 5 1/2 inch. You can keep it maximum 7 inch. Half inch I've added it so that we could stitch from the shoulder and it should not be lesser. So here we make a box and then curve it. You can make this anchor thread design on a square neck as well. Whatever shape of the neck you want, you can make that. And outside also, whichever way. I'm keeping it 3 inch from the shoulder and 3 inch from this curvy side. But if you want, you can keep it even lesser. So from top till the end, we give it a shape and then cut inner side, shoulder, and the keeping one hand on the folded side, we cut the outer line. We cut on the line. Now keeping this neck, this buckram on wrong side of the fabric, we pin it and fold the sides and make a long running stitch around it neatly. A piping can be added, a lace can be added on the sides of the neck if you want, but this is the basic neck, basic style which I am showing you. So we fold it and make a long running stitch. It is done. Now there is, you can see the ruffled extra fabric, we don't need it. So we'll cut it to separate and give a neater look to our neck. This is done. Here is the basic thing, and now you can see on the front part, this whole side was the neck, and this is the extra pleated fabric which we had. From this point till up, we'll make a long stitch and we'll firm from the end. That's it. If you want it, you can make gathers, or you can make this kind of a box pleat, and then keeping the notch in between. See, the notch comes exactly in middle of this pleat, this stitch, middle stitch, and this is our pleat. This is the extra fabric which we have, and now we'll keep our neck, this buckram neck, will notch from the middle, and from the middle we'll match both the notches. If we iron our neck from the middle, it will leave a line. Otherwise you can mark it with a chalk and make a long running stitch on top of this line. Once it is done, set your machine on a normal stitch mode and then stitch around this neckline, not on the buckram but on the fabric. It is a bit curvy thing, so you have to be careful if you are doing it for the first time. You can mark it with a chalk and stitch over that chalk line rather than stitching directly on the fabric. That will guide you easier. Till the end, we finished it, leaving about 1 centimeter or a little more. We cut around this stitch that we made. If there is like more fabric, then you may have difficulty. There would be wrinkles on the neckline, so we'll make small cuts, but the cuts shouldn't be on the stitch. It should be only on the fabric to help us turn the neck easily, and then we'll press it, make a stitch around the neckline to give a sturdy look. This way, all around the neckline, we'll make a sturdy, simple, nice stitch. This is the process we generally do to make a neck. Now we remove the pins, and next process is to use anchor thread. So this is the anchor thread. You can fill your bobbin with your hands or with the machine. These are the strands, 6 or 7 strands are there. We'll fill and then put it in the bobbin case, same as we do with a normal cotton or polyester thread. If you find it difficult to pull your thread, anchor thread, then there is one small screw here which you can loose, but remember to tighten that once your work is done, otherwise your bobbin case would be very loose and it will be destroyed. Now on the top side we fill one normal stitch, and this is our neck. We need to make a design, anchor thread design around it. On the wrong side of this buckram side, we start stitching using a regular long stitch length. If you have, you can use zigzag style also. And this kind of anchor thread designing you can make by any sewing machine. You don't need any designer machine for this. I'm using my Stitch Magic or this one, the other machine, because I was getting a bit lazy. I didn't want to remove the thread from the other machine. That's why I prefer to use this machine. But this is the simple design. You can use whichever machine you have, domestic machine or any machine you have. You can fill the bobbin even with the zari thread. You can use in the bobbin and stitch using a long stitch length. So this way you can make even the pocha for salwars. And on the towards the this neckline, I make 1 or 2 anchor thread stitches even here, so it will firm our neckline. And it will, I'm not making too many stitches, too many design embroidery designs here. I'm making it very simple, just for casual day-to-day wear for a teenage girl. But if you want, you can make it even using more thread lengths. I had shared many designs with you earlier. You can use your imagination and use the designs mentioned there and make even those kind of designs using this method. So here on the top side, on the size of this yoke, this neck, using a simple polyester thread, I'm stitching around it. This is the back side of the top. So neck, we'll fold the neck. Here also we made that pleat thing in the middle. Then we fold it from the back side. And whatever is the neck length you want, 2 inch or 2.5 inch or 3 inch, whatever you want, you cut that. And then this is the middle thing I just showed you. This is the pleated thing in the middle. There is pleat. If you don't want it pleated, you can make it simple way. Then using a dory piping thing, I stitch it around the neck to finish it. And this is one more method. You know, when I show any video, any tutorial, I don't just share one thing. I show many things, and I also explain you how best you can use this style in other designs also. See, this way you can make even front neck, you can finish the neckline of other dresses also. This way it looks nice, neat and beautiful. From the top, I made one more stitch to finish the back neckline. And here it is done. Now we'll join the shoulders, keeping the back side of the fabric of our top. Join the sleeves, the front side of the sleeve towards the front and back side towards the back. So this way our sleeve would be done. Both the sleeves will join from the sides and fold the bottom. Thanks for watching. Keep subscribed. Goodbye.